I am Joseph Aloi. I'm an MD. I'm the new section chief for the Division of Endocrinology and Metabolism. For me, within the whole broad discipline of endocrinology, I focus on diabetes and diabetes prevention, particularly for patients with type 2 diabetes. That's a research interest of mine as well as a clinical interest. The other things that tend to find me, but that I feel I have a special interest in, are people with pituitary and adrenal disorders. A medical problem like diabetes, in order for the patient to be successful, I believe they really need to understand the process, the physiology, as well as how their medicines work. Everything from understanding why we focus on a particular number or why we ask them to do something, to which isn't really as simple as, but in order to get patients to comply with the medication. I think if they understand the reasons, they don't have to be experts, but they also need first to be engaged in their care, so they have to understand it. But I really feel, and I've sort of prefaced new patients, I'll talk to them, that I feel my role is to help guide them and give them advice. I said, I'll tell you what I think you need to do, but really it's a joint decision about a treatment plan. Diabetes is really an epidemic in the United States and in other parts of the world. And with really no symptoms at all, you could be developing complications from diabetes. So how does someone really know how much attention, how much worry? And I think if you are overweight, if you have a family member with diabetes, and unfortunately, diabetes really seems to select out persons of color. So if you're Latino or African American or Caribbean, Puerto Rican, and have that, you have a very high chance of having diabetes. And recently, the U.S. Prevention Task Force recommended if you're over the age of 45, you should be screened for diabetes. Younger patients, adults, with risk factors such as high blood pressure, high cholesterol, if you're a woman that had a baby of high birth weight, or gestational diabetes, these are large groups that cover almost everybody, and my personal bias is that really any adult should be screened for diabetes. And that's an easy single blood test that can give you a lot of information about your risk.